So if you look at the market and the insurance industry, there are three key challenges, if I can just classify them. Number one is purely from a customer standpoint. You know, there has been a huge shift from a demography standpoint. You know, you have newer people coming into the insured pool. Their expectations are different in terms of how they want to engage with carriers. They want the same experience as they have when they go to an Amazon website or they look at a retail e-commerce website. So it's totally different in terms of expectations. Secondly, if you look at the core business of insurance, it's about underwriting risks, you know, understanding risks. In the last few years, the parameters that define risks have started shifting. You know, climate change, you know, cat losses, and all those things have started making a big impact in the last 3 years. So the underwriting parameters are changing, and you need more and more data points to actually be able to assess risks better. So that's number two. And number three, that's on the back end, which is purely from a claim standpoint. You know, the way, the ability to handle claims, the cost to actually, you know, repair a car or repair a home has drastically changed, in fact, gone up. So there are multiple challenges. You know, your customers are changing, your risk parameters are changing, and your claims costs are going up. So there is a big pressure on the market to respond and adapt to these changing circumstances. So, you know, artificial intelligence provides you an avenue to engage with customers in a more seamless way. You can have a lot of voice-enabled or chat-enabled interfaces driven by artificial intelligence. You can understand or predict customer behavior upfront. You know, you can understand their needs. You know, if I look at purely from a sales and distribution standpoint, engagement is one part of it, but understanding and knowing what your customer would expect 6 to 9 months down the line is probably going to change the game for carriers. And that's where AI and the power of data comes in. Traditionally, carriers used to only use data for reporting purposes. You know, you sell policies and then use the data for regulatory reporting. But then right now, what you can do is actually use that data to get more insights about your customer and bring it upfront. And then, you know your customer better. So AI can actually change the game from a purely distribution standpoint. I think two key challenges in the way I see it, right? I mean, you need to accept artificial intelligence and the power that it brings in. You know, I think the carriers will probably have to show a little bit more courage. You know, and I don't blame them for this. At the end of the day, it's a century old industry. You know, a lot of legacy systems. There are significant amount of legacy mindsets, right? So what it needs just to enhance the power of AI is for somebody to take the bold step, trust the process, and look at quick wins. You know, take those baby steps right now, and then which will give them confidence to actually, you know, transform their key processes in a whole different way in the future, right? So that's number one. Number two, I think to use the power of AI, you know, there is a big cloud component as well. You get the power of compute when you use cloud technologies. So adoption of cloud is also critical from an AI standpoint, which is also, I would think the insurance industry is a bit of a laggard at this moment from a cloud adoption standpoint. The more and more they start adopting cloud, the AI and the power of data will follow. So, you know, the way we address customer problems is in a very different way of adoption, right? We help customers understand their business problem, prioritize them, and then help them take those baby steps that I spoke about, right? You know, so our engagement journey is structured around a proven approach, which is hack it, prove it, nail it, scale it. It's a four-step process. We engage with carriers in the first step in terms of understanding the problems, prioritizing them. Second will be actually going through proof of concepts, you know, taking those small baby steps to prove out certain hypotheses and problem statements, and then take the next step of actually doing the first MVP from a engagement standpoint, and then scale it once you have proven business results. So that's how we adopt We've been talking to a lot of carriers in the last few years. We have a lot of carriers are our customers, and you know they have accepted this approach, and it has shown results. It gives a lot of visibility, right? I mean, I think what these events do is bring players like us in front of the carriers to a larger audience. That's number one. Number two, from our standpoint, we learn from the other players who are in the market solving similar problems. So you would know what the customer expectations are. So that's from our standpoint. And from an industry standpoint, they would know who are the players here, right? Especially from London standpoint, we are opening our office this year. This is our new market. And I think this event will give us the exposure needed to penetrate the market.